What is your unfair advantage in the market?
So I'll tell you the way we look at, what are our advantages and why we are, going that path. So when we speak to customers, I would not say small customers, but medium-sized and plus medium-sized and large-sized customers, enterprise customers, generally they have a preconceived notion in their head that, when I use a no-code platform, I would not, I would be, I will hit a ceiling. I will not be able to, build an app the way I would want to build, which is pro code. So if I put a developer in place, probably a developer will be able to build anything and everything that is possible. But with a no-code platform, I will not be able to do that. I'll hit a ceiling, or, I will get stuck somewhere and so on and so forth. So generally, if you look at, DroneHQ as a platform, so of course, with any no-code platform, that is going to be the case where, because what the platform provides, you will be limited with, what they provide and what you are going to build. But what we've done is we have opened, so generally we have three places where we've opened a developer interface. So while you are doing no code, while the people who are configuring are going to be business guys, but if they think that they are getting stuck or they have a ceiling, they can basically have a developer build out that small module. It can be business logic, it can be a UI control, or it can be a workflow block. So a developer can be used at that right amount of time. So just because that small module is not supported by a platform, you need not give away all the benefits that no code platform brings with you and go towards a pro code. So it's not an extreme decision to make. You can basically get a developer to write that small piece of code and integrate into the same application that you have. So we have a code block, a function editor, and a UI editor that we provide that developers can use so that they can provide a reusable component. So that is one. Second is, generally when customers go live with any application, if it's a small use case, they can go live and they can at runtime, they can iterate on that application and deploy it in production. But imagine a case where a customer goes live, with 10,000 users, and it is widely used in an organization, the whole tool that they have built or an app that they have built. And now you want to do any iterative changes. It's not very easy because you can't just do an iterative change and break the whole application that all of these 10,000 users are, building or using, on their devices or on the web. So what we have is we have something called environments. So one, we have a dev and production environment. So whenever you iterate on your application, by default, it moves into a dev environment, which only gets deployed to the dev version. So you're right from your UI to your workflow to your database, everything has a dev version to it, and you can basically at runtime you can make all of those changes. Once everything is stable, you can easily publish them into a production environment. That's second. Third is while any business guys in a large enterprise organization are building these critical applications like invoice management, for example, or inventory and so on and so forth, the data becomes very critical. The system of record becomes very critical because you cannot tamper with that data at any point of time. So when you look at those, then permissions come into play. So who has a creator permission, who has an editor permission, who has read-only rights, who has view-only rights, and so on and so forth, who has publishing rights. So we have all of those different rights built onto the platform itself. So while you are building a very serious data-intensive or data-critical application, you can use all of these things to keep your data safe as well. And last but not the least, I think the user experience of building this applications completely. So I think we spend a lot of time, getting the user experience right for everything that, users are going to use to build out these applications. So I think by far, we think we have one of the best user experience to build out any platform, any app that you would want to build.